I can't stop smiling right now because of how excited I am to finally be making another video. It's been a while, and if you want a full explanation for why I haven't been recording as often, definitely check the end of the video. I don't want to bog you guys down right off the bat, but I wanted to address something that I had a problem with during the last video. I felt like my energy was not bad, but it could have been so much better. So for this video, I have a solution. For those of you who don't know, I go to Grand Canyon University, and basically they have their own version of a Red Bull. It's called a Stampede, because our mascot is the antelope, and there's a bunch of those in a Stampede, apparently. So I'm basically gonna be shotgunning one of these things, and to prove that I'm actually drinking it, I'm going to be pouring it in a clear bottle here, and I'm gonna show you the color of the drink. I'm not gonna cut away, and I'm just gonna honestly just chug this thing as fast as possible. So here we go, gonna open this thing. This thing has been sitting in my fridge for quite a while. I'm gonna pour it into this. This is a straight up energy drink, and I'm gonna chug it. Are you ready for this? I'm ready, I'm super excited. Let's go. There we go. Guaranteed energy for this video. With that out of the way, let's go ahead and talk 21 Pilots. Guys, I'm back, and I'm super, super excited. This is amazing. I actually made a note list of topics that I wanted to talk about while I was not making videos, so I can quickly cover them in this video before heading into my main topic. The first one being the cancer video. So, I know this is old news, but I just wanted to get my 2 cents really quick. I actually want to know, does anyone else watching go to Grand Canyon University and has tried one of these? Because it's a... That's my 2 cents on that. So the cancer video, basically a lot of people notice similarities between the 21 Pilots hiatus announcement with the eye closing and the cancer lyric video, basically showing a very, very similar, if not near identical eye hidden in that video. Also, 1984 was also paired with that eye. If you guys haven't read 1984 in high school, basically it's a novel about what happens if the government becomes too oppressive or too involved in everyday lives. There's thought police, which are police that literally tap into your thoughts to make sure you're not thinking anti-government thoughts, and there's also people that are watching you 24/7 through cameras. So that is the main theory of that novel. I don't exactly know how that relates to a new album, but I do know that the 1 year anniversary for cancer is coming up, and because of that, we may be expecting something pretty soon. With that being said, 21 Pilots has been silent for quite a while since their hiatus announcement and all that shenanigans that happened. And that's, but that's kind of the reason why I haven't been uploading that much, because there hasn't been that much to talk about other than quick little social media posts by Jenna or by Tyler just hinting at things. By the way, the one that Jenna posted with Tyler playing the piano on the laptop in the plane, that blew my mind and I was really excited for it, but not a huge, but not a substantial enough topic to make an entire video about. Why I'm here with you guys now is I wanted to share my top predictions for the next album. What is it involving? What does it include? What is it not involving or include? We're basically gonna be talking about my thoughts and what the new album will contain. So we're gonna jump right into this. By the way, these are all like opinions that I've made through creating these videos, and they are not all gonna be right. The next 21 Pilots album will have Josh Dunn rapping. We've heard about this tease for quite a while, Josh Dunn honing his rapping skills. We saw in a Vine or a Snapchat on Tyler's part a while ago, showing Josh trying to rap Heavy Dirty Soul, and it's kind of adorable and amazing.
I know you can do it, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
There's an infestation in my mind's imagination, something choking with the basement.
That's good.
We also have that Trees speech where Tyler said, guys, next album, all 14 songs, Josh Dunn rapping. And the audience lost their mind.
Next time, if you keep listening, and if you just keep listening, we'll write some more songs for you and have a new record. And have all 14 songs, Josh rapping. It's gonna be sick.
Now, I know that's definitely a joke, but I think this definitely hints to the fact that Josh Dunn will have some vocal feature in the next album, and I'm super, super excited about that. My next prediction for the album, the next 21 Pilots album will not involve the color blue. Yes, I know, this is a big one, but if we go off of the theory that 21 Pilots is going to be revolving around light for their next album, I don't think that blue will be their main color. It might be an accenting color for their color scheme, like Blurry Face was black and orange primarily, with some white thrown in there, and Vessel was basically white and gray. I definitely think that this next album will go back to the white, the bright side, and I think that white or a light gray will be the main theme. Maybe blue might accent that, but I don't think that blue is just gonna be all over the place featured as the main theme color for their next album. My next prediction for the next album, 21 Pilots, the songs in this new 21 Pilots album will harken back to their first album. Now, we talked a lot about this as well with 21 Pilots kind of going back to their old feel, going back to slower songs. I definitely think that 21 Pilots will incorporate a lot of those old themes and that lyrical pureness into their new music. So I definitely think that we will expect some slower songs, some slower pieces. We will have a couple of those, you know, radio hits like Ride or Stressed Out, but I really think that most of the music will be on the somber note. It'll be slower, it'll be not as poppy or as energetic as the majority of the songs on Blurry Face. If that makes any sense whatsoever. So I just kind of want to tamper our expectations for the next album, not to be a Blurry Face 2.0, but to be its own thing, to be almost like a rebranding of the band, but not entirely, because they've produced music like that before. They're just going back to their old feel. Now, a lot of fans, I think, will be kind of split on that. I think a lot of the fans did discover 21 Pilots through Vessel and Blurry Face, like myself, so I'm interested to see how we respond to the new feel of the music. We'll have to see. My next prediction, the new 21 Pilots album will not have any remakes of older songs. People were speculating this because of the 21 Pilots lyrics flipped on reverse on their Facebook banner images a few months ago when they first announced their hiatus, and how there was Slow Town and Kitchen Sink in there, and a lot of people thought that they were going to be remaking regional at best songs. I don't think that's the case. They're not going to be focusing on old songs. They're going to be pouring themselves into brand new songs, and that is my current prediction for that topic. There may be songs that kind of harken back to those same themes in those older songs, just like Stressed Out did for Slow Town. It was a callback to that same theme of childhood, growing up, that whole sense of childlike wonder, but I don't think that they're gonna completely remake old songs. Honestly, I want you guys to ask yourself this. What if they remake those old songs and then they're not as great as you remember them, or they're not as awesome as the first version? That would backfire largely. Would you rather have that or brand new content? I would definitely be on the side of the boat that says that they want more music. I want all original music for their next album, and I'm super excited for that prospect. And this leads me to my final prediction for the new album. When 21 Pilots announces their brand new music, their brand new record, The Eye will in fact open. I definitely think that The Eye is going to be playing a big part in their new album, and I absolutely suspect the fact that The Eye will be almost like their new logo, with the logo inside the iris. That is my prediction. I really think that this is a possibility because of how heavily they've emphasized it in the past couple months, with their music video, with the Goner Sleepers Edition, with the social media shenanigans that happened in July. This is something that's big, and I think this is the brand new brand image of 21 Pilots. I would be really happy with that because I love that image. I actually used it as my iPhone screensaver. It's the banner image of my YouTube channel. I love that thing. It's really cool looking. So I would have no problems with 21 Pilots using that as their brand new logo. What do you guys think? What are your predictions for the new album? Why I love making these YouTube videos so much is because I get to see your prospects and your predictions as well. So please put your predictions in the comments below. I'm super excited to read over all those. And yes, I definitely read over all the comments. You guys are incredible. So that ends my prediction segment of this video. I'm super excited, and I've been craving new 21 Pilots music for the past 4 months. I've been craving it for a long time, but like hardcore, like itching for new music for the past 4 months. And because of that, it's been a little discouraging because they haven't been anywhere. Like Tyler and Josh, they haven't really posted anything recently. So I'm just itching for the day that that's gonna happen. It is October, and October was the month that I predicted their new album to be released. However, we'll see. I feel like I'm gonna be wrong on that, but there's still a lot of the month left. So, fingers crossed, that's all we can do at this point. For my explanation of why I haven't been uploading super frequently. When I started this channel, it was in the middle of summer. I had a lot of time and a lot of energy to basically go forth and produce videos about stuff that I'm passionate about. School kicked in, I moved here to Grand Canyon University, and I haven't had as much time, but I'm still super passionate about what I want to talk about, which is 21 Pilots. The problem is now I'm living with three other people, and sometimes it's interesting when someone else is in the room that I'm trying to record in, and my insecurities come out, and I don't want to talk about 21 Pilots. I don't even want to be in front of a camera in front of other people. So it's kind of interesting getting over that. And the moment that I started recording this, it was literally like one of the first few times that I've had the entire room to myself, able to talk about whatever I wanted to. So that's a huge factor. I will say though, however, I can't promise a weekly upload schedule like I did before, even though I'm coming out with a brand new video. But I will say, in addition to that, I'm not gonna go months and months without uploading another video. I will find something to talk about. That's also another side point to why I haven't been making a lot, because I feel like there isn't all that much to talk about and to share about 21 Pilots, and that's been a little discouraging. But I definitely will be making more videos, so count on that. For those of you who follow my Instagram, you guys get to see a lot of behind the scenes stuff, so I would definitely recommend following my Twitter and my Instagram, because you will get to see when I'm working on a video. Actually, before I started recording this, I posted a picture to Instagram saying, hey, new video coming soon. I'm actually recording it. So that's super cool. Definitely check out that social media to stay in the loop. Let's go. Also, in addition to that, I post a lot of cool stuff, so you might find some stuff that you enjoy, like 21 Pilots memes or videos, behind the scenes stuff. And whenever 21 Pilots releases brand new images or anything like that, I will be one of the first people to post about that. So if you want those current up-to-date news sources, follow those social media accounts as well. They're on the bottom of the screen. In my last video, I talked about putting something on my wall that's very special to me, and I was really excited about it. I finally have it. I put up the regional at best vinyl. And yes, it is the vinyl of Regional at Best. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pull it out here from my vinyl collection. It's two separate records, of course, two sides each. And yes, they're vinyls. They're actually vinyls. They aren't official copies. I found them on Global Groove, which is basically like an eBay source for vinyls. Like I said, they aren't official, but honestly, I don't really care. I just wanted to have Regional at Best, one of my favorite 21 Pilots albums, on this source of media, aka vinyl, and I'm super happy that I have this in my collection. So, that's awesome. That brings me to my final segment, Songs of the Week. Oh, how I've missed this. Honestly, this has been fantastic. Making this video has been a total revitalization of like energy and passion that I have for making videos, so expect more to come soon. So, my first song of the week that is by 21 Pilots is from Blurryface. It's Message Man. Why is this my song of the week? Because I finally learned how to rap all the way through it, and it's super fun to sing along to. Not my favorite song from the entire record, but definitely one of my favorite ones to sing along to now that I can rap it. So that's really fun. My second song of the week is actually from an artist that I've really fallen in love with the past couple months. His name is Lauv, L-A-U-V, and yes, that's how you pronounce it. I watched an interview and he's like, hey, my name is Lauv. And I was like, okay, it's not love, it's Lauv. But he's definitely a really cool guy, and his recent single, I Like Me Better, has definitely caught my attention for this artist. I definitely think he's actually going to be releasing an album soon because he keeps releasing singles. Easy Love was the last one. It was pretty good. It sounded kind of like elevator music, but I would recommend I Like Me Better, and if you liked that, listen to The Other, which is an also great song by Lauv. I know that's kind of cheating, two songs of the week from an artist that isn't by 21 Pilots, but he's a great guy. He's a great songwriter. He does some awesome beats, so I definitely would check him out. Thank you guys so much for watching and for your patience as well. This has been Jake with Stolen Potential, and I'm so happy to be back. Thank you guys for sticking around and now watching this. Please leave your comments below and subscribe if you haven't already. I will catch you guys in the next video. Peace out.